subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
73 years ago, Brigadier Mohammad Usman became the highest ranking official to die in action during the first India-Pakistan war from 1947 to 48. Today, I stand near his epitaph in Batla House Kabristan near Jamia Millia University, which seems to have been damaged or defaced, allegedly due to miscreants in the area. Though it is not known when or by whom the epitaph was damaged, according to locals in the area, the cemetery is not as secure as it seems, with exit and entrance gates completely open throughout the day and the night. Adding to this, one part of the cemetery is entirely open to the nearby metro station and the main road.
मैंने देखा है कि ज़्यादातर रात को भी और दिन में भी कोई ना कोई आता जाता रहता है। दोनों दो दरवाजे से ये भी खुले रहते हैं और उधर से भी टूटा हुआ है, वहाँ से भी कोई भी आ जा सकता है।
Born in Bibipur, Uttar Pradesh, Brigadier Usman was known as the Lion of Nowshera because it was under his command that India recaptured Nowshera and Jhangar in Jammu and Kashmir from Pakistan. Pakistan then declared a hit on him at a price of 50,000 rupees on his head. After partition, Usman had been given the option to join the Pakistan Army as the army chief, but declined and chose to serve India. On 3rd July 1948, Brigadier Usman died when an enemy artillery shell landed close to him in Nowshera. His funeral was attended by PM Jawaharlal Nehru, President D.R. Rajendra Prasad, Governor General C. Raja Gopalchari, and many other cabinet members.
According to Dr. Arif Ali, former professor at Jamia Millia University, the grave was renovated about 20 years ago when Lieutenant General M.A. Zaki was Vice Chancellor of the university.
Lieutenant General M.A. Zaki came here as Vice Chancellor of this university. He visited this graveyard just to find out the state of affairs here. And he saw him, perhaps he knew that he's buried here because he is known as the Lion of Nowshera or Nowshera ka Sher. And perhaps he was one of the first martyrs of independent India. So he came here and he saw this dilapidated condition of his grave. So he wrote to the military headquarters, and they acceded to his request and came and renovated it. So we were very happy, and it looked very beautiful at
Which
that
year
time.
Is this?
It was, I think, in 1998 or 99,
so
and
around,
about 20 years ago. So the whole contingent came here, they camped here for a few days, 10-15 days, and renovated this place. And subsequently upon this renovation, they used to visit regularly and keep it under watch and used to keep area clean.
Speaking to the print, a university spokesperson said that the university is mainly in charge of burial permissions, trimming the grass and clearing trash in the graveyard itself. But repairing a grave is the responsibility of the families of the deceased.
With Manisha Mondal, this is Pia Krishnakutty for The Print.